Hi everybody, it's Marquita. I was wanting to show y'all what I was making. I was watching As Time Goes By. Love my British comedies. Earlier I watched, what's the name of that new one? Open All Hours. That's the new one. I watched the first episode of season one last week. I watched episode 2 of season 1 today. So it's a new British comedy. I love my British comedies every Saturday. But anyhow, I came to show you this. I am doing the pillow cover by Mikey at Crochet Crowds. And he had a thing where he is basket weaving a, just this one side. Like, I'm almost done. I think he says 7 up. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then I'm starting. I don't know if you can see that. I'm a white. Which white? Which you go up 3 panels, 4 technically, and that will be 7. So I'm starting on my 7, and then for y'all that know me, orange and white is UT. Then I'm gonna do the other side of the pillow. Let me see if I can grab it. The other side of the pillow is going to be in blue and white for Kentucky. So this is UT Vols. For everybody that knows, I live in Tennessee. Born and raised in Tennessee. But I am not a Vols fan. I am a Kentucky fan. I only been through... Hold on. Ugh. Sorry. The glare off my computer. What's going on? Wine Country. Yeah, the one country. But I'm doing blue and white for Kentucky. So I will have a UT Kentucky pillow. And then to join it together, I am doing green. And what this will represent is the field. This is UT. This is going to be Kentucky, and this is the football playing field. I don't know if y'all seen this. I did not finish, but I still have it, which is my scarf that I started a little before. Oops, hold on. Sorry. I started this a little before winter, which is a long scarf. I did not finish it, but I still have it. I'm still hoping to finish it. I'm on this side. Hold on. I was wanting to show y'all what I did. Started with green, and it's green, then white, and orange, blue and white. So it's the field, then it is UT, then it is Kentucky, UT Kentucky, and then right here is green. Sorry. And this is the halfway point, meaning this side is one side, and then the green will go around your neck. And then I'm doing the same number that's on this side. I got I was on white, but I got one Kentucky, one UT on that side. And I haven't finished it. I was looking to finish it. I didn't finish it because I got tied up with life. And winter came and I was like, well, I don't really want to fix it. I don't really want to do it. So that's just me being lazy as usual. But, oh crap, dropped the phone. Hopefully you will like my pillow when I get done. Like I said, I'm almost done with this. And like I said, I'm following Mikey off of Crochet Corner. Crochet Crowd, sorry. Sorry I keep messing that up. I am following his pattern for a pillow. And once I finish this one, we'll start on the blue and white. And hopefully it comes out. I do not have a 16 by 16 pillow. So hopefully I can get one on the 1st of May. But hopefully I have everything done. Just when I get my pillow, I could just slide it in and close it, which, like I said, you close it with any color, but I'm closing mine with green to represent the field. And then I will hopefully slide the pillow in and finish it. You do the three sides, and then you leave the top open so you can slide your pillow in. And then you close it after your pillow's in it. So it's the pattern that if you don't like your pillow, but it's a good pillow, you know, you do that. I don't know if you can do that and like make it to where you can still change out pillows, which I think these are just like for permanent. I'm not for sure. Like, so that if you don't like the pillow but you don't want to throw it away, or you go to a thrift store and you get a pillow and you're just like, I don't like the pillow, but it's a good fluffy pillow. I think this is what this is for. But hopefully y'all like this, and like, comment, and subscribe. Hey everybody, it's Marquita. I was wanting to show y'all what I was talking about on my other videos. Like I said, this is the Kentucky side of the blanket. This is the UT side, and this will be the Kentucky side. I learned this pattern from Mikey on Crochet Crowds. I've been watching Mikey for, I've almost been living here for 10 years, so I'm gonna say 10 years. I don't know if he's had his channel for 10 years, but everything that I have made except my granny square blanket, I have learned from Mikey. So I am a hardcore fan. Now, when I very first, like, I remember I made baby booties, I made baby shorts and a baby top. I made toboggan. I made a baby toboggan. All that. All at the time, I didn't know him as the Crochet Crowd. I knew him as Mikey because that's his name, you know, Mikey. And but yeah, so I learned how to do basket weave from Mikey. I learned how to do I can't think of anything else. But, like I said, I made a toboggan, which I have a blue and white one. And, I have an orange and white one. Of course, UT, Kentucky. that I made. And then I showed y'all, I made a blue and white, or I made an orange and white scarf, and Gary made a blue and white scarf, and we gave it to each other one year for Christmas. Let me think. I'm watching Wind Calls the Heart. What else have I made? The baby booties. Hold on. I tried doing that one stitch that starts with T, tangible, I don't know. Is tagging, turkey, something. Starts with a T. Anyways, it's very, very hard. And it says it's in advance, which I think he said was a level 3. Which, if you know me, and if you don't, I am more of a level 1, probably a level 2. I made my first blanket when I was, I'm gonna say 18, and I'm 33 now. But it was a granite square blanket, and if you know what a granite square blanket is, it has 4 sides. Mine had 5, so. And then I made, I tried making, or I did make a red, white, and blue one for 4th of July. I made a green, white, and red one for Christmas. I was trying to make one for each one of the holidays, but then that's the only 2 that I think I made. That was holiday theme, because I was going to make yellow. I was going to make one that was white, silver, and gold to represent New Year's. But then I couldn't find, I think it was a silver. It was either silver or it was gold, like the sparkly yarn. I couldn't find that. It was one of them. I think they got it now. But like I said, when I was making them, I was actually, you know what? I made the Christmas one. I made a 4th of July one when I was in Western Heights. So I was like 22. But at that time, that was 2004, 2005 when I made them. And I mean, I made them really quick. And I mean, you know, if you want a blanket real fast, I say that's the best one, because it grows so fast. And then you use thicker yarn and it will grow even faster. And which I don't like thick yarn. I like, this is my go-to, Red Heart. That's my go-to. Yes, this is jumbo. And the only reason why I got this in jumbo, because white is pretty much the color that is white, you know, goes with everything. Like, you need white in pretty much everything that you do. And I try to make a blanket that was, and it was supposed to be huge. It's supposed to be able to pretty much fit a king size bed folded in half, like that big. And what it represented for me was, I had blue, which was like light blue, medium blue, dark blue, and then it's separated by one layer of white, like one border of white going around that. Then on top of that was kind of a light fuchsia, medium fuchsia, dark pinkish fuchsia. And that was in the blue I was making for my nieces and nephews, Tim, Desiree, Dominic, and Brianna. But so I'm like, blue was for Tim, the fuchsia pink was for Desiree, green was for Dominic, and purple was for Brianna. But I got all the way, I got the blue, and I got the pink. And then about time I got to, like, I did a border around for white, and about time I got that, it was so heavy and so big for me to hold that I was like, you know what, I should have just made 4 individual blankets, which I'm glad I did not finish that big blanket, even though I did it for like 6 months straight. Like this thing was already the size of a queen size bed. But I'm glad I didn't get it done. And this is the reason why. I wish that I could have did individual blankets, so I could have gave it to them on their graduation day, which Tim and Desiree, they graduate this May. So I'm glad I didn't do the big blanket, because I would have been leaving out 3 people, which is Barbara, Gracie, and Luke. They're my nieces and nephews. I love them all the same. But when I was making this blanket, I have not met, I never met Barbara, Gracie, and Luke yet at the time I made this blanket. And I'm glad I didn't finish it, because, like I said, I love them all the same, and they wouldn't have been on the blanket. But I wish that I would have made individual blankets, especially with Tim and Desiree graduating this year. Next year it will be Gracie, and I don't have a color for them. Like, I'm trying to think, I mean, I could probably do orange, yellow, like, I'm trying to think of other colors. Like, I would need 3 other colors so I could give them the same blanket. Which, and it's another thing, like, I said that I made it for them. Realistically, I probably wouldn't have been able to give it to them, because I don't tend to part from my things. To, like, I made, well, somebody threw away a blanket that was halfway made. Well, I washed it. Well, you know, I tied it off. I washed it. Then I got it out, went to the store, got the same yarn that they were using, and untied it, and then started making it. Well, I made it to where I was like, okay, well, this is a pretty good size. And my mama always says, you should make me a blanket, you should make me a blanket. And I gave that one to her. And I told her, I was like, when you die, you have to build this back to me. I don't want nothing else in your house. Like, Leisha, that's my sister, can have everything. You can give everything away except this blanket. And she laughs at me, because, like, she's like, well, I need you to come over, because I need you to tell me what you want. And I said, I told you what I want. I don't want nothing else. Like, all I want is that blanket back. I'm serious. Like, I don't want anything else from her. I just want the blanket. So, she said, I'll make sure that you get your blanket back, but I want you to have my bedroom suit, my, I think she said Murphy can have the living room suit, and then Alicia can have the dining room suit. Like, they can have, like, they can fight over the dining room suit. I don't want it. They can fight over the living room suit. I don't want it. They can even have the bedroom suit. I don't want it. I don't even want her TVs, which she got too. I don't want them. All I want is my crochet blanket back. And because I'm so attached to everything, like this, like I said, the pillow cover that I'm making really for myself, but kind of for Savannah. And if y'all know my Savannah, She has a Bumpy. And, oh, where's Bumpy? I'll show you Bumpy. Hold on. Got it. She's gone right now. Her and Gary and Hannah. But this is Savannah's Bumpy. It is so stained. She now pokes. She poked a hole in it, which Gary sewed it. But this thing is so paper thin. But she thought that was her. I was gonna say I better put Bumpy down because she will fight you. She will literally. Them little fists of fury are serious. But yeah, she don't let nobody touch Bumpy, and she carries Bumpy around everywhere she goes. But like I was saying, I'm making this not for Bumpy, but maybe as a substitute, because I'm getting another pillow. And what you do is you're pretty much joining these two things. So this is one side of the pillow, like blue and white's gonna be on one side, and orange and white's gonna be on the other side. And and then, like, the pillow's going to be in it. I decided to do Kentucky and UT because I live in Tennessee and my favorite team is Kentucky. But my favorite team will be changing as soon as I know, like, that Tim is definitely going to Appalachian State. Once he goes to Appalachian State, then Appalachian State is going to be my favorite football team until he decides to graduate. And until he gets out of college. Once he gets out of college, I will go back to Kentucky. And then whatever professional team, if he chooses to go professional, whatever professional team he's for, of course, it's going to be my favorite. Whoever he plays for, it's going to be my favorite team because Tim is my little baby man. So, yeah. But until I know, like, for 100, until, I guess, June. I don't know. I don't know when they do spring, I guess the spring training or whatever. Until I figure out if he's definitely going there, then, you know. Right now, it's going to be my favorite team. And if he does go there, then I'm going to be excited that they got a great player. Because he's really good. He's really good. Did I? Hold on. Sorry, I'm talking. Oh, Gary's calling me.
Hi, everybody.
Kita, I was coming to make a video before I showed the other video.
Really fast.
Okay. I'm home now, but I went to a doctor today and I had a
I'm okay.
I went to the doctor today and today's the 11th, and I had, I don't know, it was endoscopy, melanoma, whatever, it's something weird like that, where they stuck, well, they numbed my nose first, and they put lidocaine jelly up my nose to numb it, and I was supposed to sniff as hard as I could to get that up my nose and down my throat. Okay. And the only thing I could think of is Mary Fry. If y'all don't know her, Fry Life, go check her out. She has cystic fibrosis. She's a lovely person. But it reminded me of her when I watched her when she was getting her NJ tube. And but yeah, so it's like how they do to place an NJ tube. They stick the, this was a probe, what they did. is they stuck it up my nose. And then once I felt it in the back of my throat, then that's when I supposed to take short little sips of water and swallow as they're pushing it. And they did it on the left side. As they're pushing it up your nose. Which I can honestly say I truly know how Mary felt. So they did that. I think I gagged like 3 or 4 times. But like they do it while you're sitting down. Well, mine's because they wanted to get it to 50. I don't know what that means. They got it to 40 and it wouldn't go like anymore at 40. So I had to stand up and then they try and it wouldn't go no more. So then what I did was she told me to put my hands above my head and I did. And then I did the swallow thing and she pushed in. She got to 50. Then I sit down. It went back to 45. So then I had to stand up again, get it to where it was at 51. And then once I sit down, it went back to 49, which I lay down. She got it back to 50, taped it, and that was that. And then what they do is you do 10 swallow tests with saline. And while that's in there, she gives you a little bit of saline, you swallow it, and you try not to double swallow. And then you hold it for 30 seconds. Try not to swallow for 30 seconds. How I got through it is I had my mouth open. I was breathing through my mouth. So I didn't feel the saliva till I closed my mouth. So I don't know if that worked, if anybody's going to get it. That's how it worked for me. I double swallowed, or my throat swallowed, but I didn't swallow any saliva a couple of times, like 2 or 3 times. But she said that was all right because it showed that I swallowed, but it showed that I didn't swallow, like nothing went down. It was just my neck swallowed. I know that sounds weird. So I did that, and then the last, so you do that 10 times with the saline. And then your last test is you take a sip, or you do 3 gulps. So it's gup, 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 which with fresh water, with non-saline water. Okay, well, why are you over here?
Because I'm doing a quick video.
Okay, shh. And you do that 3 good times, which when I did that, I asked her to note that the 3 big gulps is how I feel when, like, I feel like things are stuck in my chest, which I know, like, once it go back to the bariatric people, they're going to be like, well, you're eating too fast, you're eating too much. That's not what it is, because I went back to the girl's baby spoon, like baby spoon, and like, yes, I've been eating better lately, but like, I couldn't even get like even a little piece of chicken or even shredded cheese, like cheese. Like, I can eat mozzarella, but I couldn't eat like American cheese, a slice of cheese. Couldn't even eat that, and it felt like it. I couldn't eat potatoes. I can eat mashed potatoes, but I couldn't eat whole potatoes. But now, I don't know what happened. I now feel okay. Why's your tongue out? Put it back in before I slap your face.
Don't slap my face.
Please calm down. But, so that's what happened today. So yeah, I was just making this video to put before the video of Hannah and Savannah doing gymnastics.
Hannah, Savannah, and gymnastics. And yeah. A lot of guys in my class.
I think there's like 2 boys in your class. Maybe not even two boys. It might even be one little boy now.
One little boy now.
I don't know.
But you need to get out of
my
car.
Why do you got stuff in?
Because I need to
go put it back, Savannah. I gotta go.
Hannah, get up. My mom wants to record what you were doing a while ago. Do that. Do that. Handstand like you did a while ago. Real control.
No, I'm doing a video.
Do it slow. Do that slow.
Hannah.
Your feet together. Put your hands down and you're going up.
Hannah.
Feet together. Go down and lift your foot up. Go slow.
Good job.
Do it again.
One more time.
The time you do it, the better you're going to get. No, do it slow.
Savannah, stop.
Get together.
Try it again, Hannah. Savannah, why don't you try it? Come over here. Oh, that was too fast. Yeah. Savannah. Practice.
Do it again. Do it till you get it right, baby. You did it so good. Feet together. Go up slow.
No, watch me.
Okay, well, come here, Hannah. Let her try.
Let's see how to do, like,
No, why are your knees bent?
Leave your knees straight.
No, don't bend.
Stand up.
Get away from them. Hannah, come back over this way a little bit.
This way. Now stand up. Listen. Feet together. Good job. Feet together. Pointy toes. Good job. Now kick down. Savannah, you have to learn to move your own way. Come here. Come here. I can help you, but you got to. Feet together. No, why are your knees bent? No, get up. Feet together.
How about you do a press up?
Now, bend, do not bend your knees. Bend
press
over.
Faster?
Fantastic. Good job. Now kick down.
Other way.
Good job. Good job, man. Good job, man. So then, be careful. Come over here if you're going to do better.
Five, six, eight.
Come this way. Okay.
Not comfortable.
Yeah, you can just see it.
Hold on. Yeah. Oh.
We're going to do the rock and roll. Do your rock and roll.
Put, now hold it tight.
Hold your knee tight.
Now do it.
Now tuck your head. Tuck your head. Oh. You okay?
You
keep your head tight. Go back. Rock back up. Without letting go.
Make sure you tuck your hand so you don't hit it when you go back. Good job. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Shake it out. Good job. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, put your feet together. Nope, come up a little bit more. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Kick it out. Good job. Now practice your rock and roll.
I already did.
Yeah, but you didn't touch your head like you're supposed to.
Stop. Stop.
Get over here.
Come on, get over here, baby.
I am freezing. I absolutely hate hospitals because I'm always so cold. I was coming here to make a little video. I just seen the preview of All Eyes on Me, the Tupac movie. And I'm sitting here watching and I glance, I'm like, when did Pac make that? Because I'm like, I'm looking at dude like, okay, I don't remember this movie by Tupac. I love him. When he went to a different, the blue and white version. Where's my orange one? I finished it last night. Here's the orange and white one. And I'm starting about blue and white one. But anyway, I watch Real Housewives of Atlanta. Love it. But, yeah. That movie, when it comes out, I think they said April 16th, which is Easter. Peter done went. Peter's so thirsty. I'm sorry.
I don't expect him to run through the chateau looking for me. So let me just go find him and say hello. I'm gonna make Peter be my friend.
That movie with Tupac, about Tupac, that looks like a good one, and they got a good actor to portray him. I hopefully can catch it at the dollar movies because I got kids. So when All Eyes on Me come to the dollar movies, which is $2 movies now, I'm gonna go watch that. If I don't get somebody to buy me a ticket, because tickets are $7 and I can't afford that. I know that's not a lot of money, but it's a lot of money to me for one thing. So if I don't go to it at the regular movies, I'm gonna go to it at the $2 movies.